agenda for today's meeting. We will just be sharing some national statistics, which I'm sure all of you are aware of, but why we feel that we need to monitor the situation much more closely. We will be sharing with you the rational and the conceptual framework, jaise sabhi saab ne abhi aap se share kiya, population resource center ka. This will be followed by provincial presentations, because we would very much want to know and hear that what are the provinces doing, how are they planning, what population statistics are available to them, and how they are being used at the decision making and at the planning and review stages. And this will be followed by some Q&A as well as consultative dialogue, primarily on how can we strengthen the current monitoring evaluation mechanisms for robust population statistics, which can be used at all levels for decision making, not only at the federal level, at the district level, at the provincial level, and then again at the federal level for the planning purposes. And again, as you are aware, that this is a requirement by the CCI as well, that we need to present the population progress on a biannual basis at the task force level, and rather than waiting for 5 years for the PDHS to for most of our statistics. So talking about the population dynamics, it impacts us in so many ways, that it was very rightly said by the Honorable Prime Minister that it is the denominator for almost all the problems that the country is facing. Our food insecurity, our literacy rates, our budgets, our high IMR and MMR in the region, we are the highest. And we have the highest annual deforestation in the region. And so unless this is controlled, it is the biggest impediment for economic development. We have structures and in place in the population planning, monitoring, evaluation at all different levels, which are in place, and they are playing their part. So the whole idea is to strengthen the population statistics available to them for planning, monitoring, and evaluation purposes, because we all together are working for this most important goal for the country, which is addressing the challenge confronted by Pakistan, which is the large population size, so that our planning is aligned and we have a sustainable population growth. The population planning continuum has different faces, and we have, I've just listed here the key stakeholders in the government at the government level. There is planning, resource allocation, service delivery, monitoring, evaluation, coordination, regulation. So we all have, are doing some or more of these roles. Some are support roles and some are lead roles. Outside that, there are some more actors. So this slide would have become, was becoming too long, so I've tried to club it. So if we talk about planning, the planning is being done at different levels, and it is being, there are at the Planning Commission level, at the Ministry of National Health Services for their ICT component, again at the provincial planning departments, provincial departments of health, they are contributing towards they submit their plans related to population. The population welfare department, the district submitted to the up to the provinces. Again, the Fed, there have been these federal and provincial FP task forces who are reviewing and approving, are required to approve these federal as well, national as well as provincial action plans. Again, the resource mobilization. We are coordinating, although the Planning Commission is an apex body, but that is also being done at the provincial level, being a devolved subject. At the provincial planning and development departments, the ministry is also helping in mobilizing resources together with the Planning Commission through donors, development partners, and through our own resources as well. Again, we look at service delivery. The service delivery, and I'm really glad that we have representation from the Department of Health, as population service delivery is not only the mandate of the Population Welfare Department, and we would not be able to achieve these goals alone. So it is the Department of Health where the services are being provided, the Population Welfare Department, the district health authorities for their respective districts. They are responsible for this food service delivery, and I think the most important one over here is the private sector, because to date, we are not collecting population statistics from any of the private sector hospitals. There are only three INGOs for which the data is being collected by the Bureau of Statistics, which are there, but I think this needs to be extended out if we have to do an effective monitoring. Again, monitoring and evaluation, all those who are planning, they have to monitor, you know, at their own level. Their mandates around monitoring may differ, but they all need this data for effective monitoring of what they have invested in and evaluating the plans and the policies that are instituted. Again, data analysis, where we need projections, we need forecasts, we need to see if we are off track, and then identify some deeper research needs. So the Planning Commission, being an apex body for that, is coordinating for that. But then again, the provincial planning and development departments have the Provincial Bureau of Statistics, and they are responsible to undertake these surveys. Then now we have these technical and provincial support units which are in place, and the academia and research institutions, private and public, they play a very important role. And again, then is the policy and regulatory review. Again, there are many stakeholders, and at their level they are required to undertake these policy and regulatory reviews. Again, it is the evidence which guides the policy review process, and if there is any change which is required in there. Multi-sectoral coordination, because population is not only the subject of one sector. Again, this multi-sectoral coordination is primarily being led by the Planning Commission and also by the Ministry of National Health Services, which has actively constituted an interministerial forum. And then again, at the provincial level, it is the PND department which has the ability to bring a lot of other sectors on board. The technical assistance then which is required for the planning is again can be supported by the subject matter expertise. But for all these functions, all these actors at all levels require very strong, credible and reliable population statistics. So the recent initiatives, you're all aware of, that the Supreme Court had issued the notice, after which the CCI meeting held in November 2018 constituted the national task force which developed the national plan, and following that the provincial task force have also been established and the provincial action plans are being developed. We are waiting for the first meeting of the federal task force, which is going to be this week. This is up there. The technical as well as the provincial support units have been established, and the country engagement working group meetings are being held. So these are all elements which are there, but we feel that at all levels, strengthening of population statistics is going to strengthen our ability for evidence-based planning as well as reviews. The National Action Plan, which was developed by the National Task Force, has put up some very, very strong goals and targets. It is to lower the population growth to 1.5% by 2025 and to 1.1% by 2030. And again, the CPR goals and the fertility goals have been defined. So why we feel that this is the time that we need to really work on getting some good data for helping us monitor the progress is reflected in this slide in front of you. So what we have been doing since 1990 and to 2017, we've been able to reduce the population growth rate by 4%. Whereas our target for 2025 is that we need to reduce it by 38% annually. So this really needs some ground-shaking measures that we need to take. The way that we had been planning and the way we had been monitoring, I think that this slide itself depicts that it really needs to be strengthened, and you all need to be very effectively monitoring the situation at the provincial level, and also we would want to have robust mechanism at the federal level for ICT as well as for our planning purposes, because this goal is giving you very harsh targets, I would say, because they don't seem very achievable, but we don't want to be off track as well. Our second goal is that of fertility rate, and these are the goals which were developed by in consensus as informed by the Ministry of National Health Services in consensus with the provinces, and we would want to now know that how are the provinces they have planned for these 5 years in order to achieve these goals at the provincial level. So reducing the fertility rate to 2.8, and again the fertility rate that we have currently is 3.6. Our change rate was -8% and we are targeting to -22%. So this again calls for very effective monitoring mechanism to be in place. Again, increasing the CPR. The increase in CPR since 2010 has been 6%, and we are targeting our targets, which is 50, requires us that it should be 47% reduction growth every year. So these, I mean, if you look at these statistics, so this is very challenging, and I'm hoping that at provincial level, monthly review meetings are being held in order to track their progress, because unlike previous times when we relied on the PDHS every 5 years, we wouldn't be able to wait for another 5 years to see that we are off track. We would want to set up these mechanisms where we can sit together, share successes, share lesson learned, and also take timely remedial actions. As Secretary Saab mentioned, we have number of resources available where the population statistics is there, and I wanted to share it because even at the federal level, there was not a lot of clarity that on what indicators the data is being collected. So we have MIPS, which is undertaking PDHS survey, and the Pakistan Maternal Mortality Survey is under process. They do the population projections, but as we were not moving as per projections depicted by the PDHS, we want to put in some more robust mechanism. The Bureau of Statistics, they do the contraceptive prevalence report, and they are getting service statistics from the Department of Health facilities, the PWD facilities, as well as the LHW program. There are a couple of provinces who are picking up, and we hope that all of them would start providing these stats. They are collecting statistics from only three INGOs. So the rest of the private sector, we have no mechanism in place on the basis of which this data can come up and we can have a holistic picture. There is CLMIS, which is giving us the stock, the commodity stocks, and what is in the pipeline, what has been issued, and they both of them are triangulating, but there are variances that we need to check on.